Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Now that we know how the Aldol reaction works and makes beta-hydroxyketones, let's see what we can do with them. At the top of the screen is a typical Aldol reaction. The process starts with a ketone. Step one is making the enolate with LDA. Step two is adding an aldehyde to get a tetrahedral intermediate. Step three is protonation with water to form the beta-hydroxyketone. This product is fine in its own right, but we can do more with this product, the beta-hydroxyketone. If we treat this product with either acid or base, but not both at the same time, the molecule loses water to form a new alkene. This product has its own special name, an alpha-beta-unsaturated ketone. The term unsaturated is a reference to the pi bond in the molecule. And alpha beta tells you the carbons that are part of that pi bond. First, how does this happen? The mechanism depends on whether you are using acid or base. For organic 1 classes, I normally just cover the base reaction. The base for this reaction is normally sodium hydroxide or an alkoxide like sodium methoxide. Let's use methoxide. In which case the solvent will be methanol. Methoxide removes an alpha proton from our beta-hydroxyketone to form a new enolate. Alkoxides aren't great at this reaction, but they work well enough. Once the enolate forms, it kicks out a hydroxyl group as a leaving group. Normally, when we say leaving group, we're thinking of SN2 leaving groups, like bromides or tosylates. This is not an SN2 reaction, so we need to be open to different leaving groups. Once the hydroxide is gone, we form a new pi bond. As an aside, I'm not going to go through the acid mechanism, which is longer and less connected to our enolate chemistry. So we have performed an elimination reaction. We've made a pi bond. This is not a simple E1 or an E2 reaction. If you really want to impress your friends on the social media outlet of your choice, tell them you learned an E1CB reaction. And we get lots of likes and shares, I'm sure. I don't think it's important to know the details of the E1CB, but we should quickly recognize that this transformation is definitely some kind of elimination because we've made a pi bond. The beauty of this elimination is that we access this new unsaturated ketone, our alpha beta unsaturated ketone. The CC double bond can be used in all sorts of alkene reactions, including many of the addition reactions that are covered in the alkene addition reaction playlist. So with a simple addition of base at the end of an aldol reaction, we can convert the beta-hydroxyketone to an alpha-beta unsaturated ketone, which contains a potentially useful carbon-carbon pi bond for additional reactions.